Hi everyone, and welcome to this beginner's tutorial on keyframes in After Effects. I will be covering some keyframes parameters that you can change to get some interesting results. So let's get started. First, let's look at two different types of keyframes. You can see I've got four squares here, each with two keyframes applied. They are a similar size and their behavior is the same. If we look at the values of the keyframes, we can see that they all start at 25% and grow to 100 within the course of a second. By default, the keyframes that are applied are what we call linear keyframes, and we can tell that by the diamond symbol associated with them. We can see the first difference when changing to Bezier keyframes by easy easing. So you can already see that the behavior has started to change. The reason for that is that linear keyframes are consistent. They increase or decrease with the same increment, whereas Bezier don't do that, they change. I always like to think of it as a running analogy. When you start running, you don't go to your full speed straight away. You accelerate, you run into your full speed, and then you start to decelerate. And Bezier keyframes do just that. You can best see this when we look at the graph editor. Then you will see a visual representation of what's going on with your keyframes. If you look at your linear one, you will see that it moves in a straight line. And the line corresponds to the value of your parameter within the given time. So you can see I start from 25% and I go all the way up to 100%. As soon as I look at the Bezier one, you can already see that the curve is looking different. And I get these yellow Bezier handles, which allow me to change the behavior even more. I will adjust the left keyframe by dragging the Bezier handle towards the top. And straight away I can tell what's going on just by looking at the curve. I can see that most of my movement is happening in the beginning of the animation. And if you look at the top right square, you can see what that looks like. So now let's take it even further with the fourth square. I'm going to adjust the Bezier handles in a different manner now. So again, my keyframe values are exactly the same, remember what we started with, but what happens in between them couldn't be more different. In the graph editor, I can see the curve based on the value, or I can choose to see it based on the speed of the animation. We can now look at our second square, the one where we didn't change any of the Bezier handles, and just play around with its speed. So this is the value graph for it, and this is the speed graph. I can adjust the speed by dragging the Bezier handles. And when I do that, you can see that my value graph changes as well. The reason for that is because they are connected. And if I modify it even more, you can now see that most of my animation happens exactly in the middle of my curve. And let's see what that looks like now. Another parameter that we can change is the keyframe interpolation. So you can see here that I've got four squares. Each of them have three keyframes. If I move in between these keyframes, you will see that the squares end up on the same X position at all the three keyframes. If we look at the first square, you will see that it's got linear keyframes, and again, we can tell that by the diamond-shaped symbol. If I select my keyframes and I right-click on them and go to Keyframe Interpolation, I can see that the spatial interpolation is continuous Bezier, and this is the default. What that means is that I've got these handles that you can see on the graph on the screen. You can see how my square follows the path that is shown on the screen. On the second square, I also have linear keyframes, but I've changed the spatial interpolation to linear as well. And you can see that on the graph. I no longer have the Bezier handles. The second motion pad is angled, whereas the first one was curved. My third square has Bezier keyframes with a continuous Bezier spatial interpolation. And when I play this, you can see it looks different. It sort of stops in the middle. The reason for that being the Bezier keyframe. Remember that they slow down, they decelerate, and then they accelerate again. At the moment, my fourth square has exactly the same movement as my third square. But notice what happens when I select the Bezier handles and I start changing these. Notice how the path on the screen changes as well. And this is the path that my shape will follow. At the moment, you can see that they are moving together. If I move the middle one, the left one moves along with the right one. A workaround this is to hold down Alt when changing the path. And this will allow you to only change one side of it. Again, my keyframes have stayed the same. They have the exact values in the beginning, in the middle, and in the end. But what happens in between them is absolutely different. And this is the most powerful thing with keyframes. You can do literally anything that you want with them. I hope you've enjoyed it and you learned something new and you got as excited about keyframes as I am. Read the description below for some useful shortcuts. And please let me know if anything was unclear.